Hi, Diver. What's up? Dr. Ben here again, and after a long time, today another video about how to be best prepared for the Dewey Fundamentals class. In this video, I explain how much weight you need for the Dewey Fundamentals class and for diving in general. Without any further ado, coming up. Are two main reasons for me doing this video. First, I see many students showing up for my classes heavily overweighted, and I spend always some time to convince them to leave some of their weights behind. Second, I get a lot of requests from you guys on YouTube, Instagram, and email asking me to make a video about correct weighting, so you get what you asked for. The correct weighting is extremely important underwater because it helps the diver to maintain good buoyancy, to move underwater effortlessly, and helps to preserve the environment because if you're correctly weighted, you don't bump into coral or something like that. And even better, diving properly weighted makes it safer since it helps you not to pop up to the surface or being all too heavy on the ground. So when you think of your dive equipment, pieces of it either swim to the surface or sink to the ground if you let them go underwater. If they swim, we call them positively buoyant. If they sink, they are negatively buoyant. Keep that in mind. Now, there are two possible extreme situations we would like to cover underwater. The first one is this. Imagine you're right at the beginning of your dive, let's say a deeper wreck. Your tanks are full and heavy, and after a couple of minutes, you are at maximum depth. Now, let's assume your BC fails. Bam, all the gas is gone. The question is, how can a BC fail? A high-quality BC is extremely rugged, and it's close to impossible to rip a hole large enough to lose all the gas instantaneously. But what happened to me in the past is that the outlet valve in the inflator itself failed and was open all the time. On another dive, somebody stepped on my rear dump valve before jumping into the water. It broke away and I lost the rest of it on depth. So there was a big hole in my BC and I wasn't able to use the BC properly anymore. So in case of a failed BC, you do not want to be heavier or more negatively buoyant than you are able to compensate just with your fins. Literally, if you are really heavy underwater and you do not have the possibility to inflate your BC anymore, you would want to be able to swim yourself up to the surface and hence be only so negatively buoyant that you are able to bring yourself, your tanks and so on, up to the surface just with your fins. The second situation we would like to be prepared for is this. At the end of the dive, your tanks are empty, let's say 40 bar, and hence very, very light. Maybe you carry deco tanks that are extremely lightweight or even positively buoyant, so they are literally pulling you up. In that particular situation, you won't still be able to comfortably maintain at your last deco stop, let's say 3 meters. A configuration that covers both situations, not heavier than you can lift just with your fins without BC, and not lighter than you need it to be in order to keep your last deco stop, a configuration that covers both is called a balanced rig. Coming back to your equipment and the swimming and sinking pieces, the question in the beginning was, how much weight do I need? An easy tool is to think about the pieces of your equipment and the positive or negative buoyancy they have. Let's say it's a dive to 30 meters with nitrox using double 12-liter steel tanks with nitrox 32, so very basic, very standard. So now make yourself a short table for the two situations we would like to be prepared for. Maximum depth and full tanks and 3 meters and empty tanks. Now let's list the main parts of our equipment. The regulators come with, let's say, negative 2.8 kilograms. The tanks, let's say, 12.7 kilograms. Remember that this value is only the negative buoyancy, literally the weight underwater. Double 12-liter tanks weigh more than 12.7 kilograms. But you have to add the weight of the manifold and the tank pans to the net weight of the tanks and deduct the displacement of the tanks. 24 liters from that, so this is how I come to 12.7 kilograms for standard tanks. If your tanks are different, maybe you come to different values. The backplate, let's say it's a stainless steel one, has around negative 2.7 kilograms. Lights, maybe negative 1.5, depending on the type of light and battery you have. Now, you have to take your dry suit into account. This, of course, depends largely on the type of the suit, the size of it, and the used undergarment. For now, let's go with a positive buoyancy of 15 kilo. That means with that equipment, the diver is still 4.7 kilogram negative. Now, let's switch to the end of the dive column. Everything remains pretty much the same since it does not change the weight except the tanks. Since you take gas from the tanks and this gas has some weight, they lose weight throughout the dive. A full D12 contains around 4,800 liters of nitroc-32 that weigh roughly 6.4 kilograms. So when the tanks are empty, they weigh only 6.3 kilograms. So at the end of the dive, I've got a total of plus 1.7 kilograms. That means I need 1.7 kilograms of weights to stay at 3 meters when my tanks are empty at the end of the dive. And since I'm not the kind of guy who cuts off pieces of his weights, I just go for 2 kilograms initially. All the values are very rough estimates anyway. Sure, you can at any time go to a pool with a spring scale like this and really measure every piece of equipment to make it really accurately. For me, the rough estimate is just fine. Next thing we have to check is a failed wing at the beginning of the dive. So at the beginning, the diver has minus 6.4 kilograms, so these 6.4 kilograms can be easily compensated with my PC. But what if my wing fails right at this moment, only a few minutes into the dive? Tanks really full. That means I have to lift 6.4 kilograms just with my fins. Is that possible? Yes, it is. From my experience, an average diver can lift up to around 7 kilograms. So 7 kilograms seems to be the maximum for most divers. And that is another thing you should test in a pool. Grab a weight belt of 7 kilograms and see how long you can remain on the surface holding this thing. And then retry with maybe 8, 9, 10 kilo, whatever you like. Just make sure you can drop the weight belt when you try this and maybe get a support diver in the water too. So why am I telling you all this? I see many people coming to classes with 4, 6 kilograms or even more. Just imagine if you have 4 kilograms of V-weight, non-droppable, in that configuration, that means in case of a failed wing, at the beginning of the dive, when your BC fails, you need to lift almost 9 kilograms of weight. And quite frankly, this amount of weight is just unnecessary. You need in that setup only 1.7 kilograms. If you carry more, it does not help you, but it poses a risk. If your calculation puts you in a situation where you need to have more weight because you're diving a wetsuit in a single tank configuration, making the weight or parts of it droppable by using a weight belt is a good idea and the way to go. Before we go on with how to check the weight in reality, please hit the like button, and if you took some value from this video already, consider subscribing. I do not only instructional videos like this one, but also gear reviews and a vlog from time to time, and by smashing the bell, you don't even miss upcoming videos. So after you calculated the weight you need, you can check that in reality, especially if your calculations were not really accurate. Go diving with the weight you just calculated. At the beginning of the dive, I check how much gas is in my BC by grabbing the BC from behind. If the BC is almost full in that situation, that indicates that I have too much weight. If I cannot descend, it's too little weight. What I then do at the end of the dive is I bleed my tanks to something around 20 bar and I try to descend from the surface to 1 meter. If that's easy, or if you're even dropping like a stone, you simply have too much weight. Now remove weights from your equipment, maybe pass it to your buddy, until being stable with empty tanks at 1 meter is only barely possible. For most divers, that's the perfect amount of weights, because if being stable at 20 bar and 1 meter is barely possible, it's comfortable with 40 bar at 3 meter. There are still some more questions I get frequently asked when it comes to weights, like the discussion of convex versus concave tanks, steel versus aluminum tanks, steel versus aluminum backplates, V-weight versus P-weight, and so on and so on. I'd like to answer these questions in the next videos of this series, so please drop me your questions in the comments below. And leave me a comment what you think about the importance of proper weighting, and watch my other videos. See you there.